When it was released back in 2013, Marivi Soliven hoped her novel, The Mango Bride, would help raise awareness about the plight of immigrant women who face abuse from their husbands. After winning the Philippines equivalent of the Pulitzer Prize for Literature, the Palanca Award, along with deals to publish The Mango Bride in Spanish and Tagalog, the San Diego-based author has now gone a step further. She is reaching out to real-life immigrant victims of domestic violence whose hope for U.S. citizenship are threatened by their abusive partners.
Filipino women especially are grow up with this formation that marriage is what you make of it, and you just have to endure whatever trials come your way. This whole idea of this is the cross you have to bear, you know. And so when things go awry in their relationship, they keep it to themselves because it's embarrassment for them.
According to the Asian Pacific Islander Institute on Domestic Violence, 20% of undocumented Filipino women surveyed in the Bay Area reported being victims. Soliven based the book on real phone calls she took while working in the San Francisco Bay Area as a Tagalog interpreter for a domestic violence hotline. That's why she's so passionate about this event at the Philippine Consulate in San Francisco, called Saving Beverly, named after a main character in her book. It is a fundraiser to pay for legal fees and other services for immigrant women escaping abusive situations.
I feel that I've reached out to somebody who I might not ordinarily have made contact with.
Former U.S. Ambassador to the Philippines, Harry Thomas Jr., fought hard against human trafficking during his tenure and is a big supporter of Sullivan's book and the Saving Beverly campaign.
When I'm talking about the Philippines tonight, clearly domestic violence, human trafficking is not unique to the Philippines.
Domestic violence survivor Maria Amy Santos Lyons understands the difficulty of dealing with not just the physical pain of abuse, but the mental as well.
Community events like this that puts a name to the issue, puts a face to the women who experience this, and then invites people to be a part of the solution, invites people, you know, to take responsibility for transforming the cultural violence are absolutely critical in actually stopping it.
People at this event say that by the simple act of sharing this book, it has opened up dialogue about domestic violence against immigrant women. But they say more than just talking needs to be done. It's that we as a community need to look past our shame in order to save the lives of more women facing abuse. Ramel Kinclara, ABS-CBN News, San Francisco.